Generally speaking, I do not lose my temper easily. I usually don't get mad at folks, except when I'm behind the wheel of a car. It's not when somebody else is driving, Phil's driving. I'm kind of passive and enjoy the ride, but if I'm driving, I get livid. Yesterday, I was on my way to get my hair cut on Knox Road, past OSF. I was behind about, might have been five cars, waiting at a light. And we waited and waited and waited. The light changed, and the person in the first car must have been in a coma. If I had a rocket launcher, I would have probably... there's a Highway 26. I have a little hideaway in Magnolia, Illinois. If I'm coming back to Peoria, right at 26, and I think it's 17, there's a left-hand turn, and you can turn right. And there's often a lot of cars there. And what usually happens is the person in the left lane doesn't put their turning signal on. And I could have gotten into the right lane and driven around them. And they put the turning signal on as they start to turn. Unforgivable sin. And we won't even talk about those people who poke along going 5 or 10 miles under the speed limit. Now, the worst part about my righteous anger is that every sin of a fellow driver that drives me nuts, I'm guilty. Sometimes I start thinking about something and completely space out at a stoplight. Just forget to do the basic things courtesy of the road. And yet I'm angry at others and kind of absolve myself. I guess we all do that. Jesus once said, "Why are you going after the speck in your brother's eye? First take out the beam in your own eye, and then you can better remove the speck in your brother's eye." God is so patient. God knows everything. God reads the heart. God forgoes inflicting immediate punishment. He desires the change of heart of the sinner, not their destruction. And clearly, as his disciples, we are called to act the same way. It's simply true. The sunshine we see outside is shining on saints today and on terrible sinners. The rain that'll make our crops grow, it hits everybody the same. God's gift of creation and God's offer of redemption are freely given. Now, there are times judgments must be made. Somebody who is in school, doesn't do their homework, flunks the exam, you aren't helping them by giving them an A when they deserve an F. You might have an employee who messes up seriously, endangers where you're working or other people. Sometimes you have to do the hard thing. But putting ourselves in God's place as the righteous judge, as the one who knows all things, and the one who at the end will judge the living and the dead, that is a mistake, a serious one. St. Paul says, "Why do you keep passing judgments now? Wait a while. Wait for the Lord and hear us in glory." So as we continue our Lenten journey, let us try and give up rancor, hatred, and judgmentalism, and accept the good news of Jesus Christ, and be set free.